what an answer.
A big, big, big shunt indeed. It looks like somebody either locked the brake up very badly coming in there. Mansell's showing us how the traction device on the Renault works, but Modern out of the car, Martin Brundle
in the coming out.
Yes, indeed, Martin's okay, but that was a very nasty shunt indeed. Here we see it again. Well, it's Modern now, in fact. Look, losing control under brakes, sliding heavily, and poor Martin Brundle, no idea what was going on whatsoever. Did not see Stefano Modena. That was a mistake from Modena. He locked the rear brake arm. The car went out of control, and both cars heavily damaged indeed. And well, more dismay for the Jordan team. We saw the Jordans having two cars damaged quite badly in Hungary. Poor Martin Brundle, his race car, fairly severe damage to the front of that car on the left side. The right side also damaged. And now Marshall's running all over the place trying to get Brundle's car dragged away from the line. There will be waved yellow flags up at that part of the circuit. But of course Marshall's not willing to get too close because they just don't want to be around if somebody else has the same thing happen. In the meantime, Stefano Modena looking disconsolately at his Jordan Yamaha, thinking, well, my race car or this car is certainly not going to be used tomorrow. Brundle's car, you can see damage to the right front suspension, the top wishbone bent in two, and of course the steering wheel being detached to get Martin out of the car. Now the marshal's trying to reattach it.
Going backwards, Sean, I might as well pull the car without the steering wheel being
well on. I think they must have been hearing you, Allard. That's what they're doing. You see the thing going clumpity clump, being pulled back, wishbones on the right hand side flailing around. And that was really a very, very unpleasant little incident indeed here at La Source Herpin, and just illustrates how easy it is. One little error under braking, Modena totally out of control, and once the car is sliding, it takes a very, very long time for it to eventually come to a standstill. You find that Martin Brundle's Benetton in the way and whacked into it very heavily indeed.
And they used to be teammates in Brabham back in 1989, Modena and Brundle. Well, here we see what we saw this morning, that Carl Wendlinger, although not being the fastest man on the circuit, was actually, I'm not sure whether that was right.
Well, whether it's right or not, Mansell certainly was over a second quicker at that split time. And now Martin Brundle, we're looking at him, the medical people there just having a look. He may well have had a little injury to his wrist or his thumb. You know, when a driver has a shunt like that, you're holding onto the steering wheel, your thumb is linked over the spokes of the steering wheel, and you get a very rapid whack, and that whiplash in the steering wheel can give you a damaged, you know, ligaments, or even worse, the scaphoid bone in the wrist can get damaged. Well, let's hope there's no damage to Martin Brundle, because he did get a fairly severe impact when Stefano Modena's Jordan hit him. And there you can see the right-hand rear of the Jordan completely detached.